Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Madurai, Chennai. Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Madurai, Chennai.
The pessimist sees difficulty in every opportunity. The optimist sees opportunity in every difficulty. A very pleasant morning and warm greetings to one and all present here. Hope everyone is safe and healthy. I am pleased to introduce myself as Benita Thomas, student from the Department of Human Resource Management, shall be the host for the day. MGR HR Club Connect proudly presents a national level symposium, HR Splash. This is a flagship event organized by the students from the Department of Human Resource Management, Faculty of Humanity and Science, Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute, Phase 2, Aliampattu Campus. HR Symposium is conducted to bring together the students and professionals from various institutes, universities and industries on a common platform to share their ideas and thoughts pertaining to the theme of the event. It's my privilege to extend a warm welcome to the prominent academician of our institute, Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi Madam, our Vice Chancellor. And at this occasion, I welcome our Chief Guest of Honor, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, Managing Director, Tempro HR and IT Services Private Limited. I would also like to give my heartiest welcome to Dr. A.R. Arunachalam, sir, our young and energetic Deputy Dean, Academic, Professor K. Senthilkumar, respected Deputy Dean, Administration, Dr. R. Jayam, ma'am, our dynamic and ever kind head of the department, and last but never the least, our faculty members of the department. I also extend a cheerful greetings to the eminent organizers of this symposium, Mr. Uma Kadarvel, Club Secretary, Mr. Sunil, Club Joint Secretary, S. Prince, Treasurer, and V. Monisha, our coordinator. I also feel grateful in welcoming our participants across the country to this wonderful program, HR Splash. May I now call upon our inspiring personality of our department, Dr. Jayam, head of the department, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Benita. Good morning, one and all. It's a glorious moment to extend my warm welcome to you all on behalf of the Department of Human Resource Management, Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute, University, for this one-day national-level symposium of HR Splash 2021, organized by Students Club, MGR HR Club Connect. My heartfelt gratitude to our Founder Chancellor, Dr. A.C. Shanmugam, sir, and to our dynamic Honorable President, Engineer A.C.S. Arun Kumar, sir, for their never-ending motivation and support. It's a privilege and honor to welcome our chief guest of the day, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, Managing Director, TPRO HR and IT Services Private Limited. He's not only a managing director, he's a multi-talented and knowledgeable person in various fields like HR, IT, entrepreneurship, corporate relationship, etc. Hearty welcome and thank you so much for our accepting your invitation and for your presence today, sir. It's my great pleasure to welcome and thank all the executives, deans, heads, faculty members, and all others for this national symposium of HR Splash. A very glad welcome and thanks to our joint registrar, Dr. S. Ramalingam, Dean Dr. S. Manivannan, of our Phase 2 campus for their guidance and motivation. A very special and a very big applause to my students' friends for conducting this wonderful symposium. Hats off to HR Club Secretary Uma Kadirvel for his dedicated hard work and for the effort taken for the success of this program. A very cheerful welcome to our two young and energetic deputy deans, Dr. A.R. Arunachalam, Deputy Dean of Academics, and Professor K. Senthilkumar, Deputy Dean of Administration, for their presence here and for delivering the felicitation address. Welcome, sir. Hearty appreciation to Mr. Sunil, Ms. Srinisha, Monisha, Kirtana, Prince and Dakshaini, and to all the coordinators, volunteers. You people have proved the effort of teamwork. Good work, guys. Keep rocking. Guiding, motivating, supporting, hardworking, sincerity, dedication towards the work given without any hesitation. All this is not an easy one, but I saw all these things with one student who is none other than Benicha, the overall coordinator of this event. No words there is there to appreciate you, Benita. God bless you, dear. Keep going. My heartfelt thanks to all my faculty members, Vasanti, Ramya, and Niveda Rajit, for their guidance and training the students and towards the support of for the department in all the ways. They are the pillars of my department. Thank you all to all my faculty members. Welcome to all the eminent judges who have agreed and going to spare their very valuable time for this event. Hearty welcome to you all. A very pleasant and cheer welcome to all the participants who have registered from all over India. All the best to all of you for today's event and for your future. Last but not the least, a very pleasant welcome and thanks to Mr. Ganesh Babu and Ms. Akshaya for their never-ending technical support, and a very special thanks to Ms. Akshaya for her continuous support. I want to appreciate all the students by pointing out their name, but due to the time constraint, hearty wishes from the bottom of my heart, and a very big applause to all of you for arranging this wonderful HR splash. I wish this program for a grand success. Thank you all. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your warmly welcoming each and everyone. Now, I call upon Mr. Umar Kadirvel, Secretary HR Club Connect, to give a brief introduction on the events. Over to you, Mr. Umar Kadirvel.
Thank you, Ms. Benita. Good morning to one and all. Hearty welcome to all the dignitaries and participants. It's my pleasure to give a brief about the symposium as the Secretary of HR Club. Our Department of Human Resource Management is newly started department with BA and MA course in the year of 2019. We feel proud to say that this is our first symposium which has been organized through our MGR HR Club Connect. The main objective of this symposium is to bring the hidden talents of students belonging to various teams from different institutions on a common platform where they are encouraged to share their knowledge and innovative ideas. It also aimed to exhibit the various talents and skills of the aspiring students in technical and non-technical ways. Actually, we planned to conduct in offline. As all of us know, we are in a crucial period with COVID-19, but we don't want to drop our symposium and planned to conduct in online mode with technical and non-technical events. Technical session includes two events, paper presentation and business plan. In paper presentation event, we received 261 registered participants. In business plan event, we received 19 registered participants. Non-technical session includes four events: photography, dub smash, dance, and song. In photography competition, we received 264 registered participants. In song competition, we received 100 registered participants. In dance competition, we received 53 registered participants. In dub smash competition, we received 91 registered participants. Totally, we have received 528 registered participants. Thanks to all the participants who have registered from all over the India. The above all events will be conducted parallelly through Google Meet with our eminent judges, Dr. Radhakrishnan, Dr. Valliamai, Ms. Mahmooda Begum, Professor Jeevalata, Dr. Nagaratnam, and Dr. A. Devendran after this inauguration. Shortlisted candidate lists are provided to our eminent judges. They will be selecting first three prize winners. The winners will be receiving cash prize and certificate from the hands of our Honorable President, Engineer ACS Arun Kumar, sir. Besides, all the registered participants will be receiving their participation certificate to their respective email IDs after the program. As a secretary, I thank our Honorable President, Engineer ACS Arun Kumar, sir, for his motivation and support. Thanks to all the executives, deans, deputy deans, HODs, faculty members, and to all my friends. Heartfelt thank to my department head, Dr. R. Jayam, and to all my faculty members, Ms. Vasanti, Ms. Ramya, and Ms. Niveda. A very big thanks to our club joint secretary, Mr. Sunil, club treasurer, Mr. Prince, club coordinator, Mr. Monisha, and overall organizer, Ms. Benita. And thanks to all my assistant coordinators and volunteers who have contributed a lot of making this program a grand success. All the best to all the participants, and thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Uma Kadirvel, for delivering a wonderful note on events. Now I request Deputy Dean Administration Professor to deliver the felicitation address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Pa. Yeah, good morning to Orandal connected here. It is my pleasure and privilege to be present here for this national level symposium on HR Class 2K21. I wholeheartedly thank our respected Founder Chancellor, Dr. A.C. Sandugam sir, and our Honorable President, Engineer A.C. Arun Kumar sir, for allowing us to conduct these programs. I thank our Vice Chancellor, Dr. S. Geetharshmi Madam, our Registrar, Dr. C.B. Pallivelu, for motivating, encouraging at all times. It is a great honor and pleasure to welcome our distinguished chief guest for the day, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, Managing Director, Team Pro HR and IT Services Private Limited. He has 2 decades of industry experience in the field of entrepreneurship, business development, human resource management, and corporate responsibility. We feel happy and thanks for your presence, sir. This beautiful day marks a momentous moment for the Department of Human Resource Management for producing and delivering such exclusive programs. I am surprised to see the understanding of the develop at this department and appreciate the hard work and dedication in bringing out such unique and quality programs effectively and efficiently. HRM is one of those departments which provides the golden opportunity for the student to seek training while learning. And we always encourage our students to follow our university motto, that is to be a job creator and a not a job seeker. Heartily congratulations to HR students and a special appreciation to the NGR HR club team members for organizing and conducting this program. I congratulate and appreciate Dr. Jayam, head of the department, Ms. Vasanti, Ms. Ramya and Nivedita and the delegates of PACE2 campus for inviting me to this wonderful event. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging address. I now call upon Mr. Sunil, Joint Secretary, HR Club Connect, to introduce our eminent chief guest. Over to you, Mr. Sunil.
Thank you, Benita. Good morning to one and all present here. It is giving me immense pleasure to introduce our eminent chief guest, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, who is a man of simple city. I feel elected to introduce our chief guest to everyone in a brightly sunny day. After all, he is a living inspiration to the young and energetic minds. We are very grateful to you, sir, and accepting our invitation to short notice to be a great honor. Our honored guest has 2 decades of industry of experience in role of increasing managerial responsibility in the field of entrepreneurship, business development, and human resource management and corporate relationship. He is qualified with a bachelor's degree in the computer science engineering, master's in business administration, postgraduate diploma, and master's in human resource management. Sir is also associated with a company like Satyam Computing, SIFE, student in free on enterprise, Naukri.com, and Voltech Group. He has a wide range of corporate and exposure in the terms of HR and corporate relationship and worked with the major brands in India abroad. His last assignment was Voltech Group as a corporate HR head director. Sir, instrumental in the conferencing and establishing HR department of group companies is with the more than 5,000 employees working throughout the globe. Our distinguished guest as a president more than 35 research papers in the different area HR, both in the national and international platform. He has attended seminars and training program and leading professional bodies and institute and conduct research. Was being founder of the HR service division for Voltech and Voltech Service Private Limited. Started from scratches and successfully established the business and HR in 8 countries with a 10 service and term of 110 professional and 10 years. The last venture of former speaker is heading Tempro of HR IT Service Private Limited. Established in the January 2020, Tempro is conglomeration of 3 business units, HR service and IT service and trading, operating from 6 countries. With the startup of team 35 employees, the sir is exploring avenue and crafting new business model to Tempro. Our behalf of a department and university, I welcome you, sir, and wishing you all very best in all your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sunil. It was a stunning profile. The most awaited time has arrived. Without any further delay, I now call upon our chief guest, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, Managing Director, Tempro HR and IT Services Private Limited. Sir, I request you to give the inaugural address.
Good morning to all over here. Good morning to Mr. Senthil, Dr. JM, and maybe the other dignitaries who are here online with us. It's been a great honor. It's been definitely a pleasure to have be here with you all today. It's a different experience altogether. Maybe first time for me, you know, looking at myself and speaking, something which we have done 20-25 years before, to get ourselves practiced in state speaking and self-development, look at yourself and speak. Maybe thanks to this pandemic that we are hosting an event in this manner. I appreciate Dr. NGR University and the Department of Human Resource for having taken this initiative to have collaborated ideas and bring together a symposium of this kind, and definitely a unique one of its own kind. And I understand that the first symposium, I feel sorry for the students that yes, they would love to have it offline, but unfortunately the situations are not in that great favor to them. So they have to go for this online mode, and definitely it's a different experience for all of us. Maybe you guys have got practice to it for the last 1 year by attending classes online, and you know, the speaker keeps speaking, the audience doesn't know what's happening, and you don't see the audience, so you don't know whether it is getting received or also not. But altogether, it's a great feeling. Thanks to all of you to have the patience to listen to me. And I promise you, I will not drag more than 5 to 10 minutes of your time. In this 5 to 10 minutes of time, I'll just try to share whatever best I have and learned in my experience, and whatever best I think I should share to the society back, where the young minds over there can take some learnings from there and move on in their life in a better way. And in the simplest format, let them not repeat the mistakes what we guys have done. Let them go and face the world with new challenges. As Mr. Senthil, Dean Administration, told in his speech, that let's try to be job creators and rather than job seekers. The term as such, being a job creator versus a job seeker, is definitely a motivational words. But the practicality involved behind that has a lot many things to be learned. Before getting into that part of life, that means you being a job creator, or how to become a job creator, or in technical terms, how to be an entrepreneur, is definitely very encouraging and very positive energy comes in your mind when you hear these words of being an entrepreneur. At the same time, before being an entrepreneur, I personally believe you have to be a very good human being. And the best way to be a very good human being is to learn human resource. I used to tell my employees and my colleagues, and even to the students with whom I interact, that HR, the subject of HR, is one of the most complicated subject, even though it is the most interesting as well. I call it as complicated not to make the spectrum of HR a bigger one or to boost the domain of HR in the society, but to understand the complexities involved. Let's assume, in contrary, in terms of the other departments, it can be engineering, finance, not to put anything on the other down on the other side of the discussion, but when it comes to human resource, the science behind managing human resource is still not defined. But whereas if you take any other field, it can be the engineering, it can be the biomedical, it can be even your normal medical science, the nuclear science, or even the rocket science, anything you take, there is a science behind it. Some of the sciences are explored, some of them are not. But still, there is a definition available, and there are few definitions, new definitions which will come up and which will solve those issues. But when it comes to the human resource, in my previous 20 years of experience in this space, every day has been a new learning. I used to tell, if I have two employees, X and Y, and if, let me assume, the demographic variables of both are same, in the sense they come from the same religion, same region, same class, same background, but they are two different human beings. And if I assume that they both have a same kind of problem and they approach the HR, the solution what HR has to present to them has to be two different solutions. That may not be the case in any other stream of studies. Mostly other streams of studies can operate on a defined algorithm, but human resource doesn't operate on an algorithm. And that is where the complexities comes in. And that is where people like us who are in this field of HR have to be very sensitive and have to be very alert and have to be very sharp to keep ourselves prepared to handle situations which at some point may not be in our control and which can never be predicted. And that is what makes it more interesting. And when it is interesting, it's something which you should do by loving to do it. And that's the key of HR. To be an HR, the easiest mantra is that try to be what you are. Be what you are is a four-word key which can be the easiest method of being a successful HR. You have to just remember that you are dealing with human beings. When you deal with human beings, if you bring protocol in between, if you bring policies in between, if you bring in practices in between, you may not be able to succeed. You may encounter in your professional career people with different age, different background, different caste, different religion, different language, different texture. So many demographic variations may come in front of you. At all those points, how you deal with your human beings, how you deal with your employees, how you deal with your colleagues, how open you are as an HR, how truth you are, and that all can be confined and consoled to the four single words that be what you are. And that's something very difficult, I know. In this present society where we live, we all try to pretend sometimes what we are not, or sometimes little more than what we are, both of which in my understanding is dangerous. Dangerous in the sense we are trying to pretend in terms of our language, in terms of our presence, in terms of our approach. When we try to pretend something, it doesn't survive for long. And when it doesn't survive for long, there comes the origin of contradictions. These contradictions can end up in larger issues when it comes to managing human resources. So the easiest way in my own approach and my own practice and my learning from my seniors in this industry in interacting with multiple senior HR fraternities, I have understood that a successful HR is the one who is true to what he is. He or she should not try to pretend, try to fabricate, try to manipulate. Even if there is a bad news, we should know to tell the bad news. Even if there is a good news, we should have full excitement to present those good news. There are different tricks for the trade. Definitely, on a later sessions when we can interact once more, we can definitely discuss on those areas in detail. But confined to a session of a symposium, I thought I'll just park these ideas into your mind and leave you to think more in detail how you can try to be true to what you are. True to what you are has different aspects. It can be in terms of your approach to people. It can be in terms of your interaction with your people. It can be like being open enough to say what you think rather than assuming that the other person should understand your situation. It can be even as simple as your slang. It can be as simple as respecting people. It can be as simple as just adding a word, sir, just behind even for a security guard or even for an office boy, if he is a little older than you. It can be as simple as making him or her sit in front of you and talk to them rather than showing your bosses on by making him stand and talk. So there are so many hundreds of such simple practices which keeps you to true what you are and which is what makes a huge difference in being a good, successful HR. Now, from being a good, successful HR, for me, the next challenge was to being a good, successful entrepreneur. In my experience, there is no term called successful entrepreneur. There is this, the process of venturing into creating job is an experience altogether in a different format. I remember long back, around 10 years before, one of my mentor has told me that, you know, if you are going to get into the business or if you are going to start be a job creator, then it is like holding the tail of a tiger. Now, if you hold the tail of the tiger, one, as long as you hold it, you are safe. As and when you hold it, then the game starts. You can neither leave it, you can neither hold it. Because if you hold it, you have to run behind the tiger as the tiger runs. And if you leave it, the tiger will definitely kill you. So that's the state of mind for any businessman. But as I told you, but if you're a real human being and if you're trying to leave what you are, then you can run with the tiger. You will not feel like leaving the tiger. And running with the tiger is definitely a great experience. You have to run at the speed of the tiger. You have to run at the directions which you can't predict. You have to run and be prepared for any kind of falls and harms. And those are all different experience, you know. So that's where I told you, you that, you know, being a job creator is really a great word to hear, but it is not as great to practice. And that is where I have seen in my experience, having experienced in consulting different firms, many of the companies, they have a lifespan of 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, and they couldn't sustain. The reason behind is that you cannot run behind the tiger always. You feel tired, you feel lost, you feel left out. And that's the life of every single entrepreneur. And I used to say that in India, there are two types of entrepreneurs. One, which those who are born with a silver spoon. Maybe if Ambani's son starts Jio, it is also an entrepreneurial startup. But the story for him is different. That's not the story for most of us who are here on this session. When we start a session, we will have backlashes from so many fields. Initial encouragements will definitely be there. Initial support will always be there. It's like you are getting married. That at the 1 month before the marriage and 10 days after the marriage, people will be around you. But after that, you have to live your life. This may be the one who are married in this forum can understand that. But definitely the life of an entrepreneur is not as easy as it practically looks like. And that is where you have to prepare yourself. And that's what my advice to the young generation who is here listening to me is that get yourself prepared first. Complete your graduation. Try to have a strong academic background. Beyond that, go work in different natures of organizations. Start working from a small organization, participate in bigger responsibilities. Be prepared to do anything that comes to you. Don't define yourself with your profession. If you try to define yourself with your profession, you are going to console your strength. And if you don't open up your strength, you cannot live or you cannot expose yourself to the world of job creators. The world of job creators needs the creator to be a true creator, not a just professional. A professional, a doctor for that matter, may be very good in his surgery. He may be very good in his paramedical practices. But when it comes to housekeeping, when it comes to administration, when it comes to commercial terms, he may not be that good. And that is where he may fail as an entrepreneur if he tries to put up a medical institute. That should not be the case when we venture for being a job creator. So to be a job creator, we should learn everything from housekeeping to administration to cleaning to let's say finance, accounts, branding, you know, your core functions. So those skills can impart in you only if you practice it. No institute, no company will teach you all these things. It's up to you. It's only up to you that you have to go get and practice it. No organization who recruits you as an HR or a marketing or a finance person will tell you to do housekeeping. Then you have to find out situations where you should observe, learn, and understand how it is done. And if situation requires, do that as well to ensure you that you are skill upgraded. And never say no to any single responsibility given to you, either in any format of your work. So that can bridge in basic skills required for being a job creator. So unless that foundation is set, and that foundation can be set very easily, provided you put your passion into what you do, rather than complaining, rather than comparing salaries, rather than comparing roles, rather than defining yourself. I recently remember one ex-employee of mine was here with me 2 days before. He resigned from his previous company and he was here. And I asked him, what happened? Why did you resign? So he told me, sir, I was recruited in the company as an HR recruiter. And they were asking me to manage statutory. They were asking me to manage administration. They were asking me to manage transport. And, why should I do all those things? Even though I am a recruiter, I'm a very good recruiter. In fact, that boy is a very good recruiter. I know him for almost 10 years. He was with me for 5 years. He joined with me as a fresher and got himself trained as a good recruiter. He's a good recruiter, no doubt in that. But I feel pity on him that even after 10 years of professional experience, he has not understood the essence of life. Now, the other side of the story is that he has left that job just because his boss was asking him to do manage the transportations, manage the other departments other than the core recruitment department, which was quite funny to me because he came to me and told me that, boss, I have left all these jobs. Now I'm going to start my own. And what is that he's going to do? He is going to do some kind of a trading business, and he is going to start up a new shop somewhere in Dinagar. So I asked him, now, do you have investment and how does it work? So, no, I don't have much. I'll try to do. So then I told him, who will take the delivery in that case? No, you have going to be into trading. So you have to go bring the material from the logistics points. Then he told, I will do myself. And then who will do the office keeping? You know, you have to ensure your shop is being kept clean and neat. So he told, no, that also I can manage because it's a small business. So I can find a big contradiction in his approach. That he, part of it which he was not ready to do, is ready to do on the other side of it. And how far he will succeed, I have my own doubts. Because in somewhere inside, he is not comfortable doing all this. This is not the case of this ex-person. This is the case of the most and many of them whom I have encountered in my life. And that is where when I get an opportunity to interact with future entrepreneurs, students and colleagues who really have interest to get into something and be a real job creators, I always tell them, creating job is definitely nice, it's good, you can, you will, but sustaining those jobs, you create jobs for 100 people and finally you are not able to sustain it. You ask them to leave. I have my own employees who recently have joined me, who have worked in companies which was having life of only 2 years, 3 years. Now think about the faith of those employees. You, out of your passion and money in your hand, you start a business, you recruit some 10 people, and then after 2 years, you are not able to sustain the business. What happened to these 10 people? You may lose money and you may move on in your life, but these 10 people, they have to still look for something else. They have to settle themselves in life. Those are not that easy because you are impacting somebody's life as well at this by your decisions of this sort. So being a job creator is easy, but being a sustainable job creator is the one which actually matters in this present day. So look at the parameters, practice yourself. Even if you get opportunities in smaller organizations, go take it up, explore things, learn things. You have spent 18 years learning things from different grades, from first standard, 12th, and then engineering, and so many graduations, MBA, and other things. Try to invest another 4 to 5 years on your learning. And this 5 years of learning is your practical learning. Last 18 years was your technical, theoretical learning. Now, this 5 years of your practical learning, at the age of 26, 27, when you are completely packed with knowledge, practice, and exposures, that makes you a real good entrepreneur, a real good job creator. So my best wishes to all of you. I can always be there at any time to support you. If anywhere you feel that we can be of your help, we are there to support. This is part of our social responsibility as part of our CSR Team Pro as an organization. We are bound to support entrepreneurs. We are always there behind you. Anytime you feel we can of your help, please feel free to write to us. We have a team who can always support you on that. As well, all my best wishes to the Department of Human Resource. Being the first year, I appreciate that they have taken this initiative to bring all of you together. And let's ensure we have a fine, good, great day today. There is a lot of learning for you all guys here today with your paper presentations, business plans, and the other activities around for the entire day. It's really a great opportunity. And it's a great time. You can come out of this the stagnated mindsets of being in the mid of a pandemic. These kind of sessions are really good for me also. In fact, it's been almost a year and a half not been going out and visiting any institutes or rather interacting with anybody. Personally for me also, thanks to MGR University for having given this opportunity to see you all. Rather, I couldn't see any one of you, but still I assume you are able to see me, and I hope I have done justice to the time given to me and the opportunity given to me. Thank you for all of you for being patient listeners. Thank you, so nice of you.
Thank you very much, sir, for inaugurating the gathering. Ms. Sri Kirtana is eagerly waiting to express her gratitude to everyone who helped in the success of conducting today's symposium. I hence invite her to propose the formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Ms. Benita. A lovely and warm morning to our most distinguished guest, Mr. Dinesh K. Babu, Vice Chancellor, Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi Ma'am, Deputy Deans, HODs, and faculty members. And my dear friends, it is an honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of our Department of HRM. A heartfelt thanks to our Honorable President, Engineer ACS Arun Kumar, sir, for allowing us to conduct this symposium, HR Splash. A hearty thanks to our Vice Chancellor, Madam Dr. S. Geeta Lakshmi, for her presence and raising this occasion. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thanks to all the executive, deans, HODs, faculty members, and all other for their support. A special thanks to Joint Registrar Dr. S. Ramalingam, Dean Dr. S. Manivannan, Deputy Dean of Academic Dr. A.R. Arunachalam, Deputy Dean of Administration Professor K. Sendil Kumar for their motivation and to support to us all in the way. A sincere and special thanks to our most valued multi-talented guest and Mr. Dinesh K. Babu for sharing his time and for his wonderful inaugural and keynote address. Thank you so much, sir. A hearty thanks to all the judges who accepted our invitation for judging technical and non-technical events. It's indeed our pleasure to thank our judges. Dr. A. Devendran, judge for paper presentation. Dr. R. Nagaratnam, judge for business plan. Professor Jeevalata, judge for photography. Professor Mamuta Begum, judge for dub smash. Dr. Radhakrishnan, judge for song. Dr. Valliamai, judge for dance. Thank you all for being with us today. A big thanks to organizing team of HR Splash event, Ms. Benita, Ms. Uma Kadirve, Ms. Sunil, Prince and Monisha for their contribution in making program a grand success. Besides, I would like to thank you, our various coordinators and volunteers, members of our various events. Paper presentation, coordinators K. Dakshini Devi, volunteers Archana, Rajesh, Sunil. Business plan, coordinator Shri Kirtana, Vinodini and Kiran. Photography coordinator Benita Thomas, volunteers Sham, Priyanka and Vijay. Talent show dance coordinator Sinisha, volunteers Benny Kadarvil. Song coordinators Lokeshwaran, volunteers Rajeshwari, Prince and Vanmati. Dub smash coordinator Benita, Sundar, Kumuda and Ashwin. A very special thanks to Mr. Uma Kadarvil, secretary, Mr. Sunil, Joint Secretary, and Mr. Benita for their dedication contribution in organizing such a wonderful event. Again, hearty thanks to Ms. Benita for her wonderful mastering. How will I forget to say thanks to our wonderful department people? Hearty thanks to our HOD ma'am, Dr. R. Jayam, who always support and motivate and guide all of us in all the way. She is an inspiration of all of us. She always trusts us and encourages us to do more activities along with our studies. Thank you so much, ma'am. A special thanks to our faculty members, Ms. K. Vasanti ma'am, who always advise and guide us, Ms. N. Ramya ma'am, who a friendly person who always helps in all the way, Ms. Niveta Rajat ma'am, who motivate all of us. We are fortunate to thank the dedicated and well-motivated technical support people, Mr. Ganesh Babu sir and Ms. Akshaya. A sincere and heartfelt thanks to all the registered participants from various places in India. Without you all, this symposium would have not become a grand success. Once again, thank you so much, all.
Thank you very much, Sri Kirtana. I thank all of your presence in our inaugural section. I request all the participants to join by 11:30 a.m. at the Google Meet link, which has been shared in your mail ID. Thank you all. Meet you all in the next program.
Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute.